الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد قال ابن حجر رحمه الله تعالى في كتابه بلوغ مرام في كتاب الصيام وذكر أحاديث قال رحمه الله تعالى وعن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إذا رأيتموه فصوموا وإذا رأيتموه فأفطروا فإن غم عليكم فاقدروا له متفق عليه ولمسلم فإن أغمي عليكم فاقدروا له فإن أغمي عليكم فاقدروا له 30 وللبخاري فأكملوا العدة 30 وله في حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه فأكملوا عدة شعبان 30 The author Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahimahullah ta'ala he mentioned the narration of Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله عنهما he said that I heard the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that if you see it then fast meaning the Hilal, the new moon of Ramadan. If you see it, then fast. And if you see it, then break your fast. And if it was obscured from you, meaning from your sight, you're not able to see it, then estimate the days. Then estimate for it. Make an estimation. متفقون عليه. And then in one narration from Muslim, he said, فَإِنْ أُغْمِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ فَاقْدُرُوا لَهُ 30. If the sight or the hilal, the seeing of the hilal, the viewing of the hilal is obscured, then estimate the month to be 30. What in Bukhari, and also in Bukhari, فَأَكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ 30. Complete the period 30 days. And also in Bukhari from the Haditha Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, فَأَكْمِلُوا عِدَّةَ شَعْبَان 30. Complete the period of Sha'ban 30 days. So we see that what has been established from this narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has attached the ruling of the entrance of the month of Ramadan, likewise the entrance of the month of Shawwal, with the sighting of the moon. إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ In one narration, in Bukhari Muslim, has been narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لَا تَسُومُوا حَتَّى تَرَوُوا الْهِلَالِ ولا تفطروا حتى تروه فإن غم عليكم فاقدروا له Now that do not fast until you see the new moon and do not break the fast until you see it and if the sight of the moon the new moon is obscured from you then estimate the days and you count the days So we see that the entrance of a new month will be by the sighting of the new moon If the new moon is not able to be sighted for one reason or another because of clouds in the sky or because of dust in the sky or something that is obscuring the view, then that month will go 30 days. This is the case. So the ruling has been attached to the sighting of the moon. And just in case the moon is not sighted, there has been another ruling and that is that the month will be 30 days. We've seen in our previous class, which day will the Muslims search for the moon? Layla Tharathun. On the 29th day after Maghrib, it'll be the 30th night. At this time, they'll look for the moon. If the moon is seen, the month of Sha'ban is 29 days. And the next day is the month of Ramadan. If the moon is not seen, because if there's nothing in the sky, if there's no clouds, and then the moon is not seen, then the ulama, they agreed that the month of Sha'ban will be 30 days. Naam. So there's no difference of opinion. If the moon is seen on the 30th night, the next day is Ramadan, and Sha'ban is 29 days. There's no difference of opinion about that. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَسُمُوا وَلَا تَسُمُوا حَتَّى تَرَوُوا الْهِلَالِ So this is clear for this. If it's sighted, then there's ijma' that the next day is Ramadan. طيب. If the moon is not sighted, but the sky is clear, likewise, there's no difference about it, opinion about the issue that the next day is the 30th day of Sha'ban. If they search for the moon on the 30th night and it's not seen and there's nothing obscuring the view, then the next day is the 30th day of Sha'ban, and then after that Ramadan will start. طيب, if the sky is cloudy or dusty, or is there something that is blocking the view, in this particular issue the ulama, they differed about this. But what is correct, and Allah knows best, is that if the moon is not sighted, and that is in the application of this hadith, then likewise, the ruling is that they will go 30 days for that month of Sha'ban. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he attached the sighting, or he attached the ruling of the entrance of Ramadan and the obligation of the fast of Ramadan with the coming of Ramadan to the sighting of the moon. And then he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ أَوْ فَإِنْ أُغْمِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ فَاقْدُرُوا لَهُ. Estimate that to be. Make an estimation of the days. In one narration, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he clarified that explanation. He said, فَإِنْ أُغْمِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ فَاقْدُرُوا لَهُ ثَلَاثِينَ. This particular wording here, it refers back to the hilal of Ramadan, likewise the hilal of Shawwal. فَإِنْ أُغْمِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَسُومُوا. يعني إذا رأيتم هلال رمضان فسوموا. فإن أغمي عليكم فاقدروا له 30. وإذا رأيتموه فأفطروا. يعني إذا رأيتم هلال شوال فأفطروا. فإن أغمي عليكم فاقدروا له 30. This narration, فاقدروا له 30, it refers back to the entrance of Ramadan and the exit of Ramadan. Then the other narration, the narration of there's another narration also from the wording of Abdullah bin فَأَكْمِلُوا عَلْإِدَّةَ ثَلَاثِينَ. Just in case somebody or an individual, he didn't understand the meaning, فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ, make an estimation of the days. Then he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَأَكْمِلُوا عَلْإِدَّةَ ثَلَاثِينَ. Complete the period 30 days. Complete the period 30 days. And then and this likewise refers back to the month of Sha'ban and the month of Ramadan, the sighting of the hilal of Ramadan and likewise of Shawwal. نعم فأكملوا العدة 30. طيب. And then in one narration from Abi Hurairah رضي الله عنه, فأكملوا عدة شعبان 30. This is to clarify specifically with regards to the entrance of Ramadan. So then if we see the moon, if you see the moon, then fast. And if it is obscured, then what should you do? Complete the period of Sha'ban 30 days. Complete the period of Sha'ban 30 days. There's an issue that the ulama, they mentioned with regards to the sighting of the moon, and that is with the usage of a telescope. Is it permissible to use a telescope? Shaykh Ibn Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, and likewise Shaykh Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala, they both mentioned that it's not necessary. It's not necessary to use a telescope. But if the moon was sighted with the telescope, the ruling would be correct. The ruling would be correct. Meaning it's permissible to use a telescope or some type of instrument that would make the view, the sight bigger, and to be able to see further. This is permissible because the person, he is still using the sight of the eye to view the moon. So if it was seen in this manner by a reliable and trustworthy source, it would be accepted, but it's not necessary. It's not necessary, but it is permissible. Likewise, with regards to this issue, some of the issues that we see today and differing amongst the Muslims, because some they use the hisab, al-hisab al-falaki, and they count. And they count the stages of the moon. And they say that the moon is, by their calculations, will be present on this particular day, or it will be present on that particular day. So in general, we will say to them that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he did not attach the ruling to the presence of the moon. Al-hukm laysa lahu alaqa biwujud al-qamar bal innama huwa bi ru'yatihi. It's only going to be with siding. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he attached the ruling to the siding of the moon. He didn't attach the ruling to the presence of the moon. So whether the moon is there or not, this is not our concern. Our concern is if that we are able to see it. If it is able to be seen, then there's a ruling for that. If it's not able to be seen, then likewise there's a ruling for that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not mention whether the moon is present or whether the moon is not present and the likes like this. So then, this calculation method is not considered with the people of the Sunnah. It's not considered. لَيْسَ لَهُ عِبْرَ وَلَا يُعْتَبَرُ عِنْدَ الْعُلَمَاء. The ulama of the Sunnah, they have no regards for the calculation method. And it's not relied upon. And it's not relied upon. And this is not something that is a new dispute. And this is not something that the ulama have just recently refuted. But rather, this is something that is known for hundreds of years, that they were trying to establish the ruling by calculating the stages of the moon. But something like likewise that has been established from the knowledge of astronomy and the likes is that these stages, the ulama who study the stages of the moon, they also differ. So the stages of the moon, even each stage, it has different stages and different levels. And then they differ in these things, so it's not precise. Even amongst themselves, they have differing. So in any case, whether they were correct or not correct, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he did not attach the ruling to this. Rather, he attached the ruling to the sighting of the moon. To the sighting of the moon. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned, he said, وَلَا رَيْبَ أَنَّهُ ثَبَتَ بِالسُّنَّةِ الصَّحِيحَةِ وَاتِّفَاقِ الصَّحَابَةِ أَنَّهُ لَا يَجُوزُ الْاِعْتِمَادُ عَلَى حِسَابِ النُّجُومِ. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he died in the year 728, over 700 years ago. He mentioned that there's no doubt about it, that it has been established in the authentic sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and likewise with the agreement of the companions radiyallahu anhum, that it is not permissible to rely upon the calculation of the stars. لا ريب أنه ثبت بالسنة الصحيحة واتفاق الصحابة. It has been, no doubt about it, it has been established in the authentic sunnah, likewise in the with the consensus or the agreement of the companions, that it is not permissible to rely on the calculation of the moon. He said, of the stars. كما ثبت عنه في الصحيحين أنه قال, just as it been affirmed in the صحيحين that he said صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن أمة أمية لا نكتب ولا نحسب سوموا لرؤيته وأفطروا لرؤيته. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, we are a nation that is ummiyyah. We do not write and we do not calculate. And here the meaning, وَلَا نَحْسِبُ وَلَا نَحْسُبُ يعني لَا نَحْسُبُ النُّجُومُ. We don't calculate the stars. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he has already negated this from the beginning. And this particular narration is with regards to the sighting of the moon. After this, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, we do not write and we do not calculate the calculation of the stars. He said, fast when you see it and break your fast when you see it. This narration is narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Meaning that this is from the most authentic narrations from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. لا نكتب ولا نحسب. لا نكتب, يعني the majority of the Arabs at that time, they didn't write. But there are some who wrote. But the majority of them, they didn't write. And they weren't able to count likewise in calculations. But here, وَلَا نَحْسُبُ يَنِي لَا نَحْسُبُ يَنِي حِسَابِ النُّجُومِ. This is what the reference is referring to. We do not calculate the calculation of the stars. Fast whenever you see it and break your fast whenever you see it. Shaykh al-Islam, his statement, it continues, رحمه الله تعالى, he says, وَالْمُعْتَمِدُ عَلَى الْحِسَابِ فِي الْهِلَالِ كَمَا أَنَّهُ ضَالٌ فِي الشَّرِيعَةِ مُبْتَدِعٌ فِي الدِّينِ فَهُوَ مُخْطِئٌ. He said, the one who relies upon the calculation method for the sighting of the moon or the new moon, then just as he is misguided in the legislation and he is an innovator in the religion, also he is in error with regards to his intelligence and likewise the knowledge of calculation. Likewise with regards to the knowledge of calculation. فَإِنَّ الْعُلَمَاءَ بِالْهَيْئَةِ يَعْرِفُونَ أَنَّ الرُّؤْيَةَ لَا تَنْضَبِطُ بِأَمْرٍ حِسَابٍ. He said, because the scholars of the astronomy and the likes, they know that the sighting of the moon cannot be decided precisely by a calculation. And it cannot be decided precisely and exactly by a calculation. This is the end of his statement, rahimahullah ta'ala. So we see that there's no doubt about it, that it's not permissible to rely upon that. And likewise, on top of that, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he said, the one who does rely upon this, he is misguided. ضَالٌ فِي الشَّرِيعَةِ مُبْتَدِعٌ فِي الدِّينِ. And he is an innovator. This is not from the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is not from the way of his companions radiyallahu anhum jami'an. Rather, this is an innovation in the religion. نَحْنُ أُمَّةٌ أُمِّيَّةٌ لَا نَكْتُبُ وَلَا نَحْسُبُ. وَلَا نَحْسُبُ سُمُّوا لِرُؤْيَتِهِ وَأَفْطِرُوا لِرُؤْيَتِهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, we are a nation that is ummiyah. I mean, we don't write and we don't calculate any of the stars. Fast whenever you see it and break your fast whenever you see it. طيب, this narration has a clarification for just in case. Maybe they say, well, what if you don't see it? We return back to the hadith of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, and the hadith of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, whenever the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَأَكْمِلُوا عِدَّةَ شَعْبًا ثَلَاثِينَ. نعم, فَأَكْمِلُوا عِدَّةَ شَعْبًا ثَلَاثِينَ. Or with the general narration, فَأَكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ ثَلَاثِينَ. Then complete the period to be 30 days. Then complete the period to be 30 days. Likewise, there's another issue that the ulama, they mention with regards to this narration. فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَسُومُوا وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَأَفْطِرُوا. If you see it, then break your fast. And if you see it, then fast. And if you see it, then break your fast. And this is with regards to the different sightings. To the different sightings. If the moon is sighted by a reliable Muslim in a country, is it obligatory for all of the Muslims to fast? Or is it possible that there could be different sightings? The ulama, likewise, they differ about this issue. They differ about this issue. Some of the ulama, they are of the opinion that if you hear that this is referring to the Muslims, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَسُومُوا أَنِيَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ كُلُّهُمْ. If you see it, then all of you should fast. From the understanding of this narration, meaning that if it is seen by one by an individual, or if it is seen in a manner that his sighting is accepted and established, then all of the Muslims must fast. This is one opinion. There's another opinion, but that the case is that the lands are different. If the lands are far apart, then it's possible for the sightings to be different. And this is something that Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, likewise, he has mentioned that there's no doubt about that this occurs. That if the lands are further apart, then it's possible for the moon to be sighted at different times or in different days. That this is something that is established. طيب, then there's the issue, even if it's established that the moon could be sighted here and not sighted there, or sighted there and not sighted here, still there's the issue of the sighting, the when one person sees it, whether it's sighted here or there. If it's sighted by a reliable person, the people, the ulama, the first opinion, they still say, whether the difference of the matada is established, the reality is that if the moon is sighted, there must be a fast by all of the Muslims. In any case, the ulama, they differed about this. But there's a narration from Quraib. Quraib is from the Tabi'een. This particular narration is in Sahih Muslim. Naam, it's mentioned Sahih al-Imam Muslim. He mentioned with his chain of narration, he says, "An Quraib to Quraib." He said, "Anna Umm al-Fadl bint al-Harith ba'athathu," or it's mentioned that ba'athathu ila Muawiyah bil-Sham. That it was mentioned that Quraib, Umm Fadl bint al-Harith, sent him to Sham, to Muawiyah in Sham. قال قريب, he mentioned, قدمت شام فقضيت حاجتها واستهل علي رمضان وأنا بالشام. He said, so I went to Sham and I took care of her business for her, and then the beginning of Ramadan occurred while I was in Sham. Now at this time, this is the time in the Khilafah of Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, and he was in Sham, in the area of Sham. So Quraib, he is in Sham along with Muawiyah. And the moon was sighted there and they fasted. Naam radiyallahu anhu. So he says, Quraib, he mentioned, فَرَأَيْتُ الْهِلَالَ لَيْلَةَ الْجُمُعَةِ. So I seen the hilal, the new moon, on the night of Jumu'ah. وَقَدَمْتُ الْمَدِينَةَ فِي آخِرِ الشَّهْرِ فَسَأَلَنِي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma ثُمَّ ذكر الهلال. He says, so he's seen the moon on the night of Jumu'ah. And then in the end of the month, he returned back to Al-Madina. While he was in Medina, he met Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. And Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he asked him about the hilal. So Quraib, he mentioned to him, فَقَالَ Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said, مَتَ رَأَيْتُمُ الْهِلَالِ فَقُلْتُ رَأَيْنَاهُ لَيْلَةَ الْجُمُعَةِ قَالَ أَنْتَ رَأَيْتَهُ فَقُلْتُ نَأَمْ وَرَآهُ النَّاسِ وَصَامُوا وَصَامَ مُعَاوِيَةِ. نعم. So Abdullah ibn Abbas, he asked him, did you see the moon? He said, yes, we saw it. He said, you saw it? He said, yes, I saw it, and the people saw it, and the people fasted, and Muawiyah fasted. And the Imam, the Khalifa, radiallahu anhu. He said, we've seen it Laylatul Jumu'ah, the night of Jumu'ah. So then Abdullah ibn Abbas, he mentioned to him, radiallahu anhuma, وَلَكِنَّا رَأَيْنَاهُ لَيْلَةَ السَّبْتِ فَلَا نَزَالُ نَسُومُ حَتَّى نُكْمِلَ ثَلَاثِينَ أَوْ نَرَاهُ. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said, but we did not see the moon until the night of Saturday, the night of the Sabt in Medina. So in Sham, they saw the moon on the night of Al-Jumu'ah, and they began fasting. And the people saw it in Muawiyah, the Khalifa radiallahu anhu, fasted from the next day on the Sabt. Whenever they returned, he returned, Abdullah ibn Abbas, he says, radiallahu anhuma, we did not see the moon until Laylat al-Sibt, the next night. So they're a day behind in Medina. They're in Sham, they began their first day on Saturday. Naam, the first day of fasting. Because they seen the moon, Laylat al-Jumu'ah, the night of Jumu'ah. So they began their fast. Huh? Yawm al-Jumu'ah. Ahsan, jazakum Allah khairah. Aywa, on the day of Jumu'ah. And then Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, we didn't see it till later to Sibt, any Friday night, the night of Saturday. So they began fasting on the day of Saturday, a Sibt. Naam, in this manner. So they're a day behind. So then Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, okay, this is the case. We didn't see it until the night of Saturday. Abdullah ibn Abbas, Zakham Allah khairah. Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiallahu anhuma, he said, we did not see it until the night of Accept, and we will remain fasting until we complete 30 days or until we see the moon. We did not see it until the night of Accept, and we will remain fasting until we complete 30 days or we see the moon, the new moon. So Quraib, he says, فَقُلْتُ أَوَلَا تَكْتَفِي بِرُؤِيَةِ مُعَاوِيَةَ وَصِيَامِهِ. Quraib, he said, he asked Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, and he said, would you not suffice with the viewing or the sighting of Muawiyah and with his fast? So he said, radiallahu anhu, Abdullah ibn Abbas. فَقَالَ لَا هَكَذَا أَمَرَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. He said, no, like this, in this manner, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم has commanded us. Has commanded us. نعم. So this is established here in this narration, the understanding of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, and that this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had commanded them. That these, they fasted on a different day. And the first day of Ramadan was established on a different day in Sham than it was in Al-Madinah. And then whenever he found out about that, he didn't change the days of the fasting. Rather, he said, this is how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded us, and that we will either complete 30 days or we will see the moon. And we will not suffice with the fast or the sighting that was in Sham. And likewise, from the ulama, they mentioned that, you know, this to make this opinion, or what strengthens this opinion, is the fact that Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, he did not command the people to go out. He did not send out messengers throughout the land, obviously to here in Medina, to inform them that they saw the moon and that they must start fasting. He didn't send out messengers to Medina or to the other neighboring lands to inform them when they saw the moon, which is indication that they have the opinion that the moon should be sighted in each land. In each land. Naam? So we see that the major scholars of ulama, they have mentioned, the board of major scholars in Saudi Arabia and Saudiya, they have many fatwa with regards to this from them. They said, وَقَدْ مَضَى عَلَى ظُهُورِ هَذَا الدِّينِ مُدَّةُ عَرْبَةَ عَشْرَ قَرْنًا. They mentioned that 14 centuries have passed over. This religion has been proceeding for 14 centuries. وَلَا نَعْلَمُ فِيهَا فَتْرَةً جَرَى فِيهَا تَوْحِيدُ أَعْيَادِ تَوْحِيدُ أَعْيَادٍ إِسْلَامِيَّةٍ عَلَى رُؤْيَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. He said, after all of these centuries, from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his companions, and the tabi'in, and tabi' tabi'in, and tabi' tabi' tabi'in, all the way until the period of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, and then after that, rahimahullah, to the period of Shaykh al-Islam, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, all the way until our period now, in the period of Shaykh al-Islam, Shaykh ibn Baz, and the mashaykh of our days, like this, there has not been established that there was one singular sighting, and that all of the Eids were established on the same day in all of the lands of the Muslims. This has not been something that has been affirmed or established. They said, and وَبَقَاءُ الْأُمَّةِ عَلَى مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ وَأَنْ يَكُونَ لِكُلِّ بَلَدٍ إِسْلَامِيٍ حَقُّ اِخْتِيَارِ مَا تَرَاهُ بِوَسِطَةِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. This is what is correct. And this is what is, and هَذُهُ الصَّحِيحِ. So they said, and that the ummah should stay in the manner that it has been. Because there are people today, they try to say that they want to unify the Muslims. Unify the Muslims by unifying the sighting of the moon, and by unifying the Eid, and by unifying the coming of Ramadan, and unifying the fast, and all of the Muslims, if they fast all at one time, this will bring unification. And if they all have Eid at the same time, this will bring unification, and the likes like this. But the Board of Major Scholars, they have established that this has not occurred in the history of Islam, from the coming of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that there was unified days of fasting and unified days of fasting and unified days of the Eid. So to leave the ummah in the manner that has been until now, this is the best way. This is what the Muslims were upon. Alhamdulillah, that every land, that is every Islamic land, they will establish the moon according to their sighting, naam, or according to the ulama of that land. If the ulama of that land and the rulers of that land decide that that land will follow the sighting of any Muslim, then this is permissible. And any Muslim country that establishes the sighting properly to follow that person, this is permissible. Or to follow that country, this is permissible. Or for every country to have their own sighting and to search themselves, likewise, this is permissible. So the affair will go back to the ruler of the country. The affair will go back to the ruler of the country and to the ulama of the country. The kind of like today the ummah is divided into countries, separated into different countries. So every country, it has their right to choose. This is the meaning of the fatwa, that they would choose according to any the help and the aid of the ulama, of the ulama. So then, if a country sees that it's permissible to follow the fast of another of any Muslim who is established in the world, that a reliable Muslim has sighted the moon, to follow that sighting and to fast that day, this is permissible. Or if they have the opinion that rather that we have our own sighting in our own land, in our own country, and they prefer to follow this opinion, then likewise this is permissible. This is permissible. And the individuals who live in that country, they should follow their imam with regards to that. They should follow their imam with regards to that. So, for example, if there is a country that is going by the sighting and another country says, no, we're going to go by our own sighting, then those people who live in that country should go by the command of their imam and be unified with their imam. Because the Prophet ﷺ, he said, As-sawmu yawmi yusumun nas. The fast is the day that the people fast. Wal-fitru yawma yuftirun nas. And the breaking of the fast is the day that people break the fast. So this is the case. This is the case. The opinions are two, and it's permissible to follow either way. And this will go back to the command of the ruler of that country, according to the advices of the ulama. Then there's the issue after that of the Muslims in the Jariyat. Naam, and the minorities in the disbelieving countries. The Muslims that live in a disbelieving country where the moon is not established and the likes like this, for example, like in America. Shaykh Ibn Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, he has a fatwa with regards to this. And he mentioned, it was asked specifically about an issue in Hind. But he mentioned in his fatwa that this is included, his advice is included for Hind and all of the disbelieving countries like America. And he mentioned this directly, like America. And he said that what the Muslims should do and what his advice is that they should try to follow this narration and follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَسُومُوا. And likewise, the coming narration also of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam command the people, they would go out and look for the moon. So Shaykh ibn Baz rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned that this is what he advised the Muslims and the disbelieving countries to do, to establish a jihad or an organization that is reliable and that will search for the moon. That would establish the moon according to the Islamic manner, according to the Sharia of Allah Azza wa Jal. That would establish the moon either by sighting it in these lands or by going 30 days. This is the advice of Shaykh ibn Baz rahimahullah ta'ala, that the Muslims, they should form a group of people that will be entrusted to this, that are reliable, that will search for the moon, that they can rely upon, and if they see it, they will fast. If they do not see it, then they will go 30 days. But he said, rahimahullah ta'ala, if they are not able to do that, for whatever the case may be, it's permissible for them to follow another country, a Muslim country that is reliable, that sights the moon according to the legislative sighting. For example, he said, like the kingdom of Saudi Arabia, it's permissible to follow them. So if there is a sighting, it's possible to be sighted by an authentic source and a reliable source in this land, then one would fast according to his sighting. And this is legislated. And if it is not cited, and it's possible that it was cited in another Muslim land that is relied upon, and the manner in which they established the sighting, then to follow them likewise is permissible. To follow them likewise is permissible. So this issue would occur, for example, if I'm not aware of another Muslim country that would establish it properly, besides the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. They're known for their reliability in establishing the Sharia, and in general, and establishing the sighting of the moon according to the legislated manner properly by the sighting of the eye. So then it would be permissible to follow them. It would be permissible to follow them. But if there was a case, for example, that the sky, the viewing was obscured or was not sighted in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, then that would be around Dhuhr time here. They will search for the new moon around approximately and the Dhuha and the Dhuhr time here. So if the moon is not sighted there, then they will declare that Ramadan is 30, that Sha'ban will be 30 days. And then the Ramadan will be the next day. And that's according to their sighting. And to follow them is permissible, but we still have the issue that possibly it could be sighted here. Possibly it could be sighted here. So then, for example, we wouldn't want to start sending out the messages all this, because if it's sighted here, then and somebody didn't follow that sighting, then he would be possibly, the Prophet said, if you see it, then fast. So it could be cited by a reliable source. A reliable source meaning one that has a reliable deen first. He's not an innovator, or he's not a disbeliever. Before that, he's a Muslim. And he's not an innovator from the different jama'at and the different groups and the different the ahzab and the likes like that. We wouldn't accept their sighting. But if it was cited by the layman of Ahl Sunnah, or by the students of knowledge, or an individual from Ahl Sunnah, and he's clear that he's upright in general in his religion and his creed and his belief and the likes like this, and he has a good eyesight, and he's known to be somebody who, whenever he speaks, he makes tathabbut. He doesn't just speak about stuff without any verification. He makes verification in general in his speech, and he has good eyesight, and he is an upright person as far as what is apparent upon the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then his sighting would be accepted. His sighting would be accepted. And Allah knows best. But this would also go back to the community. The community, they make the decision, and then the people, they follow the community. Those who in the community, they follow the community. But if the community, for example, or the people in a particular masjid, they say they follow the hisab, we don't follow them. It's not permissible to follow the hisab. And then other people, they say, well, okay, we want to follow the jama'ah. We want to follow al-jama'ah. We want to be united. We want to be united. Unification will never be upon innovation. وَاعْتَسِمُوا بِحَبْرِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. The one that made tafarruq is the one that is not holding on to the habl of Allah. The one that is not holding on to the Qur'an. The one who is not holding on to the sunnah. Or the one that is holding to the Qur'an and sunnah and something else, this one he has made tafarruq. But as for the one that's holding on to the Qur'an and sunnah, then this is what is obligatory. and to be united with them. And the Quran and the Sunnah with this regards is to fast according to the sighting of the moon, not to the calculation. Not to the calculation. So the one who is in accordance with this, he is the one who is upon the truth. Al-jama'ah man wafaq al-haq walau kunta wahdak. The one who is in the jama'ah is the one that is according to the truth, even if an individual is by himself. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Idha ra'aytumuhu fasumu, wa idha ra'aytumuhu fa'afthiru." If you see it, then fast, and if you see it, meaning the hilal, then break your fast. فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَاقْدُرُوا لَهُ ثَلَاثِينَ أَوْ فَأَكْمِلُوا عِدَّةَ شَعْبَانَ ثَلَاثِينَ أَوْ فَأَكْمِلُوا عِدَّةَ ثَلَاثِينَ. It's all clear. The methodology of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in establishing the sighting of the moon. Either it will be sighted and that month will be 29 days, or it will not be sighted and that month will be 30 days. And Allah knows best. After this narration, the author, he mentioned, رَحِمَ تَعَالَى وَعَنِ بِنِ عُمَرَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا أَنُّهُ قَالَ تَرَأَ النَّاسُ الْهِلَالِ فَأَخْبَرْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَنِّي رَأَيْتُهُ فَصَامَ وَأَمْرَ النَّاسَ بِسِيَامِهِ رَوَهُ أَبُو دَاوُدَ وَصَحَّهَهُ إِبْنُ حِبَّانُ الْحَاكِمُ. He mentioned the narration of Abdullah ibn Umar رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا. He said that the people, they went out to see and to search for the hilal. تَرَأَ النَّاسُ الْهِلَالِ. And تَرَأَ خَارَجَ النَّاسُ جَمِيعًا يَبْحَثُونَ يَنْظُرُونَ عَنْ الْهِلَالِ يَنْظُرُونَ يَبْحَثُونَ عَنِ الْهِلَالِ. They're looking for the hilal. تَرَأَ النَّاسُ الْهِلَالِ. The people went out, they all went out to search for the hilal. He said, so I informed the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that I saw it. And he fasted and he commanded the people to fast. This narration is in Sunan Abi Dawood and has been authenticated by Ibn Hibban and Hakim. Likewise, the author, he mentioned the next narration. He said, وَعَنْ إِبْنِ عَبَاسٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمَا أَنَّ أَعْرَابِيًّا جَاءَ إِلَى النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَقَالَ إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ الْهِلَالِ فَقَالَ أَتَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ قَالَ نَعَمْ قَالَ أَتَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ قَالَ نَعَمْ قَالَ فَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ يَا بِلَالِ أَنْ يَسُومُوا غَدًا رَوَاهُ الْخَمْسَةُ وَصَحَّهُ ابْنُ خُزَيْمَةَ وَابْنُ حِبَّانَ وَرَجَّحَ النِّسَائِيُّ إِرْسَالَهُ. The next narration the author he mentioned was from the narration of Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما that a desert Arab, Arabian, from the outskirts, from out of town, not from the city, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and he said, verily I saw the new moon, I saw the hilal. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked him, do you testify that there's nothing worthy of worship except for Allah? He said, yes. He said, do you testify that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah? He said, yes. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, O Bilal, announce to the people that they should fast tomorrow. Announce to the people that they should fast tomorrow. This is narrated by Al-Khamsa. Al-Khamsa, what does that mean? Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Nasai ibn Majah, idafatan ila dhalika, al-Imam Ahmad fi musnadihi, naam. As-Sunan al-Arba'a, the ulama, they say al-Arba'a, As-Sunan al-Arba'a, these are the four books of the Sunnah, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, Nasai, wa ibn Majah. If you add to those four, two more, which are the most authentic books, al-Bukhari al-Muslim, al-Sahihain, we say al-Sitta. If you mention the Arba'a, and along with that, Imam Ahmad in his Musnad, we say al-Khamsa. If we mention all of them together, Saba. This is from the terminology that the author he used in this particular book. And he is a great scholar of hadith. A great scholar of hadith, particularly Mustalah hadith, but in fiqh likewise, in the deen in general. Rahimahullah ta'ala, and he has a methodology in the manner in which he authored this work. And many of his mustalahat have been relied upon. And they are the agreed upon mustalahat that are used, any terminology that are used for the ulama until today. Because of our class time and preparing for Ramadan, we're not going to go into much detail with these particular mustalahat. Inshallah, if we have a chance to study the book from the beginning, we can discuss that in more detail. Now,
what if one country and a neighbor, say, versus one country, they start fasting like on a Friday? And in this country, a neighboring country started fasting on a Saturday. The first country fasts 29 days. The other country cites the moon at the same time as the other one, so it naturally they only fast 28 days. That ever occur?
Nam, it has occurred. If it ever occurred that this happened and they fasted 28 days, then they will make up a day. They will have to make up a day. The ones who fasted 28 days, they will have to make up a day. Because like, for example, on the 28th day, then the moon is sighted. They see the moon, khalas, the next day is Eid, they make up a day. The next day is Eid, they make up a day. Nam. And this has occurred. There are narrations with regards to this. Barakallahu fikum. Nam. So the narration here of Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu anhuma, is established, and it is authentic narration. The narration of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma is mentioned here. We left off with Rawahul Khamsa. وصح ابن خزيمة وابن حبان ورجح النسائي إرساله. So this narration was narrated by Al-Khamsa, and it was authenticated by Ibn Khuzayma and Ibn Hibban. The narration of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma and Al-Nisa'i has considered this narration to be mursal, meaning it's a weak narration. It's a weak narration. So, Shaykh al-Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala, he has made ta'if of this particular narration. But in any case, the author, he has mentioned these two narrations now to establish a new issue. The manner in which the author, rahimahullah ta'ala, he has established or made tartib and arranged these particular narrations in this chapter of fasting is tartib badi' jiddan. He began the chapter of fasting with introduction to fasting. We see the first hadith. What did he mention? لا تقدموا رمضان بصوم يوم ولا يومين. And then he mentioned after that the narration, من صام اليوم الذي يشك فيه فقد عصى أبو القاسم. These are all with their introduction before Ramadan. And then after that he mentioned the narration of Abdullah ibn Umar on the established how Ramadan is established. إذا رأيتموه فصوموا وإذا رأيتموه فأفطروا. نعم. And now he continues now to establish the issue that sighting. Can be established by one Muslim. إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ It could be understood from this narration, بَارَكَ فِيكُمْ جَمِيعًا إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, that all of the Muslims have to see it. If you all see it, because it's in the Sigat al-Jama' in a plural form, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, if you all see it, then fast. So somebody may say, I didn't see it, I'm not going to fast. Well, all of the Muslims have to see it before we fast? Is that the proper understanding? لَا. Rather, what is required to fast is that one person who has the requirements for his fast to be, for his testimony to be accepted, then this is the one that would establish the obligation of fasting. This is why the author, he has mentioned this narration. The narration of Abdullah ibn Umar, radiallahu anhuma, what did he mention? He said, tara an-nas, that the people, they went out to see the moon. Naam, tara an-nas al-hilal. فَأَخْبَرُتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ أَنِّي رَأَيْتُهُ. I informed, he's one person, صح? I informed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that I saw it. Naam. So what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam do? وَأَمَرَ النَّاسَ فَصَامَ وَأَمَرَ النَّاسَ بِسِيَامِهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he fasted, and he commanded the people to fast. He commanded the people to fast. Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah ta'ala, he also narrated this narration, and from the commentary that he mentioned after this narration, he said rahimahullah ta'ala, والعمل على هذا الحديث عند أكثر أهل العلم قالوا تقبل شهادة رجل واحد في الصيام وبه يقول ابن مبارك والشافعي وأحمد وأهل الكوفة. الإمام الترمذي, he mentioned that the application of this narration is that the ulama, the people of knowledge, they're in accordance with the application of this narration, and they have mentioned that the testification of one man will be sufficed with. Yani what we can suffice with the testification of one man with the coming of Ramadan, with the establishment of the obligation to fast. And this is from the opinions and the position of Abdullah ibn Mubarak and Imam Shafi'i and Imam Ahmed and the people of Kufa, Ahl Kufa. Who are they? Huh? Aywa, they're in Ahl Kufa? Aywa, Al-Ahnaf. Abu Hanifa wa ashabuhu rahimahullah ta'ala. Naam. But he mentioned likewise with regards to this, وَلَمْ يَخْتَلِثْ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ فِي الْإِفْطَارِ أَنَّهُ لَا يُقْبَرُ فِيهِ إِلَّا شَهَادَةُ رَجُلَيْنِ. He said, but the ulama, they did not differ about the fact that with regards to the iftar, they will not accept except the testification of two men. Naam. But the ulama, they mentioned with regards to this, the establishment of the new moon, one person. Naam, this is what this narration indicates. And Imam al-Tirmidhi, he's mentioning Allah was that the ulama, they did not differ about the obligation of the leaving of Ramadan and the coming of Eid. It has to be established by two, the testification of two individuals. And even the ulama, they have mentioned that the testification for the coming of Ramadan, for the sighting of the moon of Ramadan and the beginning of the obligation of the fast of Ramadan, can it be established by one man or by one woman? By one man or by one woman? And it's understood from this narration that the tara an-nas, and this is in general, the people, they went out to see it. Now the people, they all went out to search for it. The ulama, they mentioned, because why? Because this is al-khabar al-dini. This is a religious information. And this is news that is being related with regards to the deen. So it is similar like the shahada of a narrator. Because in those who narrate narrations, this is a testification. This is a shahada. And with regards to, because this is a narration in the deen. So then a narration of a woman would be accepted. And there's narrations of women. Narration of Aisha radiallahu anha. The narration of Salama radiallahu anha. The narration of Hafsa radiallahu anha. Doesn't have to have two women narrate the particular narration for it to be accepted. This is with regards to an issue in the dunya issue. In the deen, la. One narration of a woman could be established. As is in the case here with the sighting of the moon. Either one, if it's one man or one woman for the sighting of the moon of Ramadan. The sighting of the moon of Ramadan. Al-Hafiz al-Nawawi, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned with regards to the issue of the sighting of a woman for the month of Ramadan or a man. He said, وَهُوَ الْأَصَّحُ لِأَنَّهُ خَبْرٌ دِينِي لَا تُهْمَتَ فِيهِ وَأَحْوَطُ لِلْعِبَادَةِ وَأَحْوَطُ لِلْعِبَادَةِ. So the ulama, they mentioned that, you know, for the coming of Ramadan, they have precaution for the entrance of Ramadan. They take precaution by accepting the testification of one reliable Muslim. And likewise, for the exit of Ramadan, there's precaution by not only accepting for one, but rather for two. So for the coming of Ramadan, they have ihtiyat, and taking precaution by accepting the narration of one reliable individual. And this is accordance with the narration of Abdullah bin Umar, tara an-nas. فَأَخْبَرْتُهُ أَنِّي رَأَيْتُهُ I informed them that I saw it. فَصَامَ وَصَامَ النَّاسَ أو فَصَامَ وَأَمَرَ النَّاسَ بِالصِّيَامِ Naam, but as for the leaving of the month, and for the exit of the ibadah, then it's only accepted the narration or the testification of two reliable people. So we see with regards to the issue that this month of Ramadan is established by the sighting of the moon, whether it is sighted or not. This is how the ruling is established. And that by unifying the people and by trying to make all of the people fast in the same day, this is actually not unification. This is not the means of unification. And this has not occurred in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He did not command this, for all of them to be fasted all together on the same day, or to use the calculation method. This is one of the shubuhat that the people of the Hisab, yani the ones who use the calculation method, they use that we want to unite the Muslims. We want to have all the Muslims fasting at the same time. We want to bring unification to the ummah and have them all having Eid at the same time. This will unite the Muslims. But this is not the means of uniting the Muslims. And this has not been established ever since the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that all of the Muslims throughout the world fasted in the same time and broke their fast in the same time. And this is not the case. And that they all have Eid on the same day. This has not been established from the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam until today. But the reality is that if we want to unite the Muslims, then we have to call them to the correct creed and the correct belief and the correct methodology. And this is what will unify the Muslims. Not by all fasting on the same day, or all by all having Eid on the same day, all eating on the same day and drinking on the same day and the likes like this, but rather by all having the proper belief and the proper creed. All having the proper belief and the proper creed. This is the manner to unite the Muslims. And in any case, the ruling is established to the sighting of the moon. And it's something that all of the Muslims can see. It's not as, for example, if the ruling was established to the calculation method, I would not be able to calculate. I don't know how to calculate. And the majority of the Muslims, they don't know how to calculate the moon stages and the stars and the lights like this. The majority of, this is for the specialists and those who have this, that specialize in this particular field, those who are able to calculate the moon and the stages, and those who are able to calculate the stars and the lights, and to know when the moon will be present and will not be present. All of this is something specific. Yani for special individuals in the rulings of Islam, they are not specialized for only particular individuals to be able to identify them. Rather, the rulings of Islam are established and they're made general. All of the people are able to establish them. All of the people can go and look and see the moon or not see the moon. This is something that is general and easy for all to do. And likewise, the times for Salat. We see that whenever the Fajr comes in, it's by looking at something that is general, all the people can see. All the people can look in the horizon and see whenever the light is present across the horizon, know that now it's time for Fajr. It's not relied upon having the calculator know. And if it, like, these rulings are established with in a general manner for all of the Muslims to be able to establish and know what is obligatory upon them. Likewise, whenever the dhuhr comes in is whenever the shade, it comes to a halt and then it stops and starts moving again. This is something that anybody can look at, it can see the shade. Whenever the shade becomes as long as a person, or the shade of something becomes the same length of that thing, now the dhuhr is gone. This is something that all the people can see. The times of Salat, they're attached, the rulings of the times of Salat, they are established in a manner that all of the Muslims can identify them. The sun, when is the iftar, or when is the maghrib, whenever the sun goes behind the horizon, this is something that all of the people can see. The rulings of Islam are general, and they're easy for all, and they're not made specifically for one group of specialists and the likes like this. So even the calculation method, this is not the correct way. And this is not the way of Islam. This is not the way that Allah Azza wa Jal, He has commanded His servants to establish these rulings and to understand them. Rather, they're in general ways. They're in general ways. So we wouldn't follow these ways, the ways of the calculation method. Just as Shaykh al-Islam mentioned, rahimahullah ta'ala, this person is misguided and this person is astray, and he's an innovator and he is erred with regards to his intelligence and with regards to the knowledge of the hisab. So the author, he mentioned the narration of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and after that the narration of Abdullah ibn Abbas. Inshallah we'll continue tomorrow. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.